there's no staring at our bottoms as we walk along the skyway this year. No siree, Bob.
Did you say staring at our bottoms?
I said staring at our bottoms, Bobo. That's what these people were doing. It was unsavory.
They were looking up our skirts.
They were looking up our skirts, looking at our hoo-ha, checking out our ding-ding, look at our bottom. Everybody knows you don't look at a man's bottom when he's walking across the skyway. You don't do that. You might see the drugs somebody keeps up there.
So it's Friday morning, not even noon yet, we're into the bottom comedy.
Let me tell you something. Why start at the top?
Hey, I didn't set my watch, so to me it's 3 o'clock.
You're right. Why start at the top? We can start at the bottom.
At the bottom? Starting at the bottom.
Listen, everybody, Robbie. We have all of you here. Robbie, why'd you start this? Why did that be divisive? You're the Donald Trump of this stage. I want everybody together. Everybody together. Not divided, together.
Richard.
Yes.
Rich. No. Richard. You promised me you wouldn't say the T word. First of all. Second of all, I'm not the enemy here. Like, your weird, odd, sexy dance is not going to get you out of this thing.
So you're admitting it's sexy?
Admitting it's odd. If you're into the odd stuff, he's your guy.
Hello? Well, hey, friend.
Ooh, watch how
what's going on over there?
Huh? Yeah, that's a real okay. Yeah, ooh, so hot. Wait, did that thing where you did it, like you took a turd with the microphone? That really got me going.
I call that Bobby getting the drugs out of his B.O.
That is not, why am I, I'm standing here.
I know, it's amazing you can stand so naturally with all those narcotics up your chute. It's shocking.
I always hated the days where he's like, you know, Bobby, we're gonna go out there this morning and I've got nothing to say. So I need your help. I'm like, you got it, Richie. I got you.
Clunk in, Bobo! Clunk in!
We get out here, and then you're like, all right, we do this? He's like, he's got drugs in his butthole. Why are you? That is not okay.
Well, here's the thing about it. Right now, in this moment, there's nobody in this room that can prove that you don't have drugs in your meal.
Sorry,
it has been said, it is out there. I don't know who started it, but the conversation has begun. Now, where do we go with the conversation? I don't know. Let's see where it takes us, Robbie. But let's not close doors. It got brought up, okay? It got brought up. We can spend all morning. Don't do that. We can spend all morning trying to figure out who brought it up. That's a fool's errand.
Right. Well, except that I know. I'm sure we've got video. We can rewind.
Okay. You know what? Nobody believes video anymore. Hashtag fake news. No one's gonna believe your doctored video of me saying what I just said 2 seconds ago. No one's gonna believe it. All right? So drop it.
All right.
Point is, the you b-hole drug issue has been brought up. It hasn't been talked about. And now, it does, we can go back in time and waste all that time to figure out who said it, why they said it, or if it's true or not. And now we gotta deal with what are the ramifications of Rob's behold this pack full of drugs. We can't prove that it's true. That's true, we can't. But we can't prove that it's not true. So it leaves it hanging out there and it could make this weekend awkward. I say let's not let it do that. Let's not let this weekend be ruined by Rob's drug-filled behold. Let's be bigger than that. You too, Robbie. I want you to sail
above
this.
Rise above it.
Rise above this. Rise above this like a stoic boat-driving man.
There you go.
In troubled waters.
That's a recall right
just
there.
Piloting his boat through choppy waters. I can always tell when Rob's completely clocked out. He's like, good one, Rich. Oh, you're brought it back. Okay, good.
Hey, speaking of this weekend.
Yeah.
All right, everybody.
Everybody. From Robbie's B-hole and rather snake tame the dragon.
These guys get it. They get it.
Yeah, they're going out to find their own drugs.
Nope.
Kids, don't do drugs unless you get from Robbie's B-hole. All right, so now it's break time, autograph time, photographs. Listen, we promised you at BorCon you would be bored, and I think we have delivered it.
We got proof.
As I stampede for the door.
Don't hurt yourself.
We're getting the hell off the stage what we're doing, but you, sir.
Hi, I'm Kevin.
Hey, Kevin.
I love you guys.
Thanks, buddy. Man.
I got a question for Rich.
Hi.
I've been curious for the last 2 days.
A few days.
About what drugs are up Rob's ass.
Oh. That's a fair.
Well, I got these for you to try out.
Okay, what are they? Bring them up. They're rubber gloves?
Yes. Can you find out what they are and tell us, please?
Yeah, okay. We can do that. We can do that. Thanks, man. Appreciate that. Safety first.
I got a thing, guys. I'm going to.
This is great. Now, hold on, Robbie. This is just rubber gloves.
Oh, no, no.
Let me tell you something. The man asked a legitimate question. Here, you can have one in case you want to.
This. What? This is one of those scenarios.
What?
Where you have created lie out of thin air that has nothing to do with anything, and now it's a thing. It's reminiscent of the Rob hates Perth thing where all of a sudden Rich decided, I hate Perth, Australia, city I've never been to. I don't have any opinion, but I love everything, so I'm sure I'm going to love it. But Rich says to the people of Australia, this man hates Perth, and now there are t-shirts. Google Rob hates Perth, and you will see a slew of t-shirts, and you ask
high quality shirts, nice shirts.
And you say to, and he's made half of them, and you say to this man, why did you just say that? And he's like, hey man, no, we're all curious why you hate Perth. Now, the drugs up the butt thing.
Here's the thing.
And you're giving me a full cavity search.
I'm trying to answer a man's question.
All right.
He wants to know what narcotics you keep up the chute.
All right, let's do it.
That's not unreasonable. It reminds me of Rupert.
Yeah, totally.
Yeah, the we'll move on for the Rob narcotics
native
question.
No, please. I don't mean.
But I just... It's one of those things at this point, it would be great if you're
flowers,
like...
Flowers, rabbit,
Tylenol bottle.
It's really not much, guys. Advil.
A pharmacist. Hello? Thank you for getting me out of this bottle.
Claustrophobic in there.
The drug in your bottom thing, I don't know how it started. I don't know how it started. I don't. It happened
in
a committee.
You might have been in a city that was drug friendly, say Seattle.
Makes sense.
That, you know, where pot is legal.
Right. Yeah.
And then all of a sudden, like you do, it came around to, I've got it in my butthole.
And there was a song that came out of that.
There was a song.
Bobby drugs in the butthole, Bobby, something like that. Oh, Bobby drugs in your butthole.
It's the hit.
Bingo, bango, babo.
But yeah, you actually made up a whole, like, there was a whole thing.
Yeah.
But was it?
You'll find the thing online. You'll find the thing for us and you'll tweet it out.
Just search drugs and Rob's b-hole.
I got news for you. If you search drugs and Rob's b-hole, prepare for a long feed. It's a lot of, this has come up on stage a lot.
Here's a question. Was it when I got stopped going into England? It might have been that. I got stopped going into England because we were in a band and we didn't have a work permit, so we got deported.
Right.
It was just an uncomfortable, bad situation that we're just some musicians.
Right.
No drugs involved. Maybe it was that.
I don't know. I don't know. I just know that now it's become a thing, and now it's one of those things that it's out there, so we can fight against it, but we can't disprove the theory, so we might as well just...
I want this picture online. We're like...
Just having an honest conversation. Here's the thing. Two men in rubber gloves having a frank and honest conversation about the narcotics you keep in your anus. Oh, it's a microphone. Anyway, thank you for the question.
Thank you for the question. Thank you for the gloves.
Thank you for the gloves. The gloves are really nice.
What are some fan art forms that you haven't seen that you would like to? If Matt was here, I'd tell him I'd like to see him portrayed as Magic Mike, because he likes to get down and dirty in karaoke. Rob, I'd like to see portrayed as either biblical Jesus or God. And then Rich, you're gonna love this, Azrael gave me her blessing. Okay, so I'd like to see you carved out of the Moby, which is $550, 3 foot long, and the world's largest retail redacted on Amazon. That way girls can say they saw some really good looking redacted.
I don't understand anything that would be said there. I don't know. I'm carved out of $550 of what?
$550, it's 3 foot long, it's the world's largest retail, I'm gonna say it, dildo, so that way people can say it's not a really good dick.
I had no idea what that was being, where that was going.
Yeah, so
you
can have a dick dick.
Ah, I get it. That'd be like your pharmacist.
Right, just like my butthole pharmacist, exactly. This is one of those topics.
Oh, God. If there aren't shirts that have Rob's butthole pharmacist on Redbubble by the end of the weekend, you people have failed me.
We're talking about your dick dick right now. You go first. Dick dick or?
I don't think there's a question in there.
Her question was, is there any fan art of yourself that you haven't seen that you'd like to? Personally, I've seen a lot of great and creative stuff.
Yeah.
Dude, new song.
You had no mic. I was free.
Rich.
What?
You got a message.
What's up?
What did you find?
And it'd be home?
Yeah, what'd you buy?
We're going to have to tweet that out. The list is long and most of it is in sort of a Latin-y, medical speak. So we'll post that out.
Roses.
Yeah. Roses, please. Bye, everybody. See you later tonight.